this is the preparatory step for the Japanese overlay technique called Nunome-zogan. Nunome means or refers to cloth weave or woven cloth, and looking at the cutting on the ground, you can see why that name is appropriate.
So here you can see me holding the chisel. As I described, the narrow face is pointing towards me, my thumb on one side, two fingers on the other, and then the chisel tip there, you can just see resting on the pad.
Moving away from me as I'm cutting away, and that short face relatively vertical. So this is a pusher for applying gold foil. It's more a matter of rolling the tool so that the texture engages with the silver and forces it into the teeth. Now that I know the foil is secure, I'm going to use a burnisher. Right, so I'm going to apply a little bit of gold wire. This is 24 karat pure gold, and it's 0.1 of a millimeter in diameter. Now I want to change direction again, put the pusher down, bring the wire around, align it where I want it, and secure it, and move along that line. It's important to keep the wire under tension, just enough to keep it straight. So what I'm going to do now is come back, and I'm always working towards myself, rather I'm pulling the wire in the direction I want to go, and I'm securing it as I go. Just as a tip now, I'm going to ever so lightly scribe, not really scribe, but just scratch very loosely. So I'm not keeping the gold wire under as much tension now, because I'm trying to create a more natural curve. This is incidentally the kind of technique that's used to decorate the famous Meiji period Komai Nunome-zogan.
Well, I hope you've enjoyed watching this short trailer film showing some of the intricacies of classical Japanese Nunome-zogan. If you'd like to see the full 32-minute film, please consider joining me on my Patreon channel. That's www.patreon.com/FordHallam, and there'll be a live link in the description below this video. I hope to see you over there sometime. Thank you for watching this film. Bye.